So I'm Faris. I am a UI engineer at Frappe, and I've been at Frappe for more than 5 years now. And I work mostly on UI, and my last project was the front end of Frappe Cloud. So if you have used Frappe Cloud, that was my last project. So today I'm going to try to demo how have some lag. Okay, cool. So today I'm going to try to demo how to build a hackathon website in a day, within a day. So before all of this, when I say hackathon website, what I really mean is I want to build a web application. And in 2021, if you want to build a web application, what do you need? You need to choose a stack first. Then by a stack, I mean you choose the backend, and we have all these options, and then you have front end. And then you create your models to store your data, and then you create HTML pages to display your data in the browser. Then you also need to accept data via forms, and you also need to manage sign up and user sessions. But what we already know is Frappe framework solves all these problems. How? You don't need to choose a stack. You can create doc types from the UI, and you can model it however you want. You can create web pages to display the data. You can accept user data via web forms, and you don't need to manage user sessions. All of that comes right out of the box in Frappe framework. But what about our use case? We want to build a hackathon website, and Frappe framework is a generic web framework. So for that, we have custom apps, and for custom apps, you need to create a Git repository, and you create a doc type. Then you write controller code, then you write HTML pages, then you test it, then you push it to GitHub, then you deploy it, and if you found a bug, you repeat all those steps again. So again, I'm pitching here the low-code version of Frappe framework. So Frappe framework has various features that let you skip all of this. So when you do that, you don't need to create a Git repository. You can create a custom doc type. You can write controller code and server scripts. You can create web pages. You can just test it live, and you can just skip the deployment steps. And if you found a bug, you can just fix it live. So what are we building? So we had this Mumbai hackathon event that we used to conduct that stopped in the pandemic. So what I'm imagining here is if we conduct an online virtual collaborative hackathon, what would it look like? So it should have some registration for projects and members. It should have a list of projects that you can browse. Then it should have some sponsorship ability for individuals or companies to sponsor the event. Then you might have some social interaction features. It'll have landing pages obviously, and you might also need to publish a schedule. So this is what I'm going to try here. So So I am logged into Frappe Cloud, and I'm going to build this live right from creating a new site. I'm going to name this HackathonCon Demo. And I really don't need any other app, just Frappe framework. All right, so our site should be ready in a few minutes. All right, the site is ready. I'm going to log into it. Quickly complete the setup wizard. All right, so the first thing that I would like to do is create a landing page that might say our event is coming soon. So you just create the first page. So I have everything ready so that you don't have to see me type everything. Okay. So if you're wondering what I just did is I use the copy to clipboard feature that you can find in any document. Okay, so I'm using web page and the content type page builder. You have used the latest version of Frappe. I'm going to name this by hackathon. View it, it looks something like this. I have the hero section. We have some speakers, rules, and the schedule. So yeah, our homepage is ready to go. One thing that you need to do is from website settings. Set this as the home page. So what this will do is when people visit your site, the first page will be this one. All right, the next thing I want to do is create a custom theme for my website. So let's create a new website theme. And I have this ready as well. Okay, so what I have done here is I want a black and yellow theme for my site, and I also use the custom Google font. And we have a couple of fields here. This one is primarily used for overriding Bootstrap 4 variables. So if you know how to customize Bootstrap 4, then this is the field that you do override those variables. And this field is where you can write custom SCSS. So I did some basic theming. I'll save this. Okay, so the one caveat of copy to clipboard is it won't create links. So I'm going to create my color quickly here. This should be fine. And don't forget to set it as the default theme. Now let's check our homepage. Cool. So this is how I want it to look like. Now, if I go back to website settings, I want to add my logo in website settings. So for that, I have some links in the navbar. I have the logo, which is not uploaded, which I'll upload it after this. And I have some footer links. All right, I'm going to upload. So my logo is here and my links are there. Now, I think the landing page is ready to go. The next thing we want to do is ability to register your project. So for that, for tracking projects, we'll create a new doc tag. Let me quickly create hackathon project logline. So I'm going to namespace all of this in a new module called hackathon, so that everything is organized properly. And I have basic fields like title, description, and a table where we'll keep track of the members that are working on this project. So this is a table, so it has to be created first. So I try to save this. I want to make the project member doctype first. So I'll do that in another tab. The project member is a child table and has basic fields for tracking the number. Cool. So now my hackathon project doctype is created. And if I go to the form, I have this form ready. But your participants won't be getting access to this admin UI. So what you really need is a public facing web form that they can use to fill up the information. So next we'll create a web form. Okay. So I'll call this my project, because we want them to create a new project and also edit it later if they want. And this will be based on the hackathon project doc type. So if they submit this form, a new hackathon project will be created and we use the same fields. We save and check our web form. This is how it looks. And this is accessible at this URL /my project. So if you notice in the navbar, what I did is added a link to the My Project web form that any participant that has created an account can access this. So let's just test this in a incognito window. So this is how everyone will see the website. And first they need to register. So let me register it. Okay, so in their case, they'll check their email. Here I'm directly going to set the password so that I don't have to do that. So I have registered and now I can access the My Project web form. Let me create project. Let me add some description here. I'll add Suraj as my teammate. Okay. So now if I check the hackathon project list, we have a record. All right. So now next thing we want to build is the browse projects page. Right now, there is no page, but we'll create one. Let's go to the page and create a new page. So this will render on the slash projects route. And I've used the content type HTML where, and also checked dynamic template. So what this will do is this will enable Jinja templating. So you can fetch whatever data you want to render on the page from your doc types. So this is the template field. And here we are setting the context. So what I'm doing is fetching all the hackathon projects and ordering by some field and then using Jinja templating to render Bootstrap HTML basic. So let's see how this looks. Good. So we have the list, and what you also want is a detail page for the project. So let's build that next. So here we are using dynamic route feature where you don't know the exact route because a part of the route is dynamic. So here name will be dynamic, and using it we'll fetch the relevant project, and that value will be available in frappe.formlet. So using that we can just do frappe.getdoc and set it in project and use that information in our template. So let's see this in action. I click on this. Our template will render here. Cool. This looks good. Okay, so here I want to mention these APIs. So what we are using here is a limited set of APIs that is available for use in server scripts, web pages, and all the features where we use dynamic Python. So to test that, you can use system console. If you are a system manager, you can access this tool. And what you can do is test out your script. So store the results here. And you can execute it inline and you'll see the output here. So this way you can test your scripts before putting them and using them in reports, server scripts, or web pages. So this is a quite handy tool. You also have SQL mode, so you can directly write SQL. And run it, and it will render as a table. So this is pretty useful in building apps like this. Okay, back to projects. All right. So what we also have here is upvoting. So in hackathon project. In hackathon project, there's a upvotes field, which is read only. So how to track upvotes? You can create a new doc type and record every upvote for each user. So let me do that quickly. So I'm going to create a new doc type called hackathon project upvote. And it only contains project and upvoted by. And the logic is whenever someone creates hackathon project upvote, the upvotes field in hackathon project should update. So for that, we'll use server script. So we'll name this update upvotes count, and it will based on a doc type event. So whenever we create hackathon project, the doc type event is before insert. So whenever we create a hackathon project upvote, it will get the hackathon project and update the upwards value by one and save it. That is all we want to do. Cool. So we can test this by creating a new hackathon project upwards and selecting a project and save it. Now if I go to this, upwards is one. So that is what we want. But we want this on our web page. So whenever someone clicks this, it should update. So here this is not working because this should ideally do an API call. So what I have done in the template is it is a HTML form which does a post request to this URL slash API method upload project. So to do this, we need to create another server script. And this time it will be API. This upload project. And the API method will be upload dash project because that is what this matches here. Cool. So what we are trying to do here is just creating a new hackathon project upload document and just creating that document. The rest will be handled by the other server script. And we are also redirecting to the same page. Let's save this and try this here. Cool. It works. So that is server scripts, doc types, web pages. Let's do some integrations. So I mentioned sponsorship payment. So we want to allow sponsors to pay us. And let's create a doc type to track that first. So I'm creating a sponsor type, and we are again adding basic fields like email, company, and amount. Let me save this. So how I want this to work is, sponsor clicks on payment link, pays the amount, and then through some webhook, it updates in our system. So in this case, I have already created payment links in Stripe. I have a Stripe test account and I've created three tiers of payment links, gold, silver, and bronze. And I've also set up a webhook that will hit our API endpoint here at the sponsorship payment. So we know how to handle this. We will create a server script. So let's try to do that. So before that, we'll create a web page where sponsors can click on the links and make the payment. So for that, we'll create a web page. And I have it ready. The content on this web page is basic hero and three links for the three tiers. If you click on a link, I can do this here. Click on a link. Stripe throws you to the payment page directly. You can make the payment. So what we want is to handle the webhook. For that, we'll create a server script. And the script type will be API, and API method will be sponsorship payment. This is the route that is set in Stripe. Name this on sponsorship payment. And we'll allow guest so that we don't need authentication. And I've already gone ahead and checked out what data Stripe sends. So to fetch the data here, we need the email and the amount. And we are also setting the type of tier based on the amount. So if we get $100, we will set it to bronze. If we get $300 to silver, $500 to gold. And we are just creating a new sponsor document and inserting it. So let's try this. So this is a test account. So I'm using Stripe test credentials that will always succeed a payment. If you notice, it redirected me to sponsorship details, which I had configured in Stripe payment links. So on this page, you can have a success page, success message that saying thank you, or you can point them to another route. But yeah, let's check if our script worked. Cool. We got this. So what you can do is create a web form for this and let the sponsors update the company info. I'm going to skip that because I have already demoed web form. One more thing that I would like to show is, so here at Fapay we use Telegram a lot, and for the past couple of months we have been using Telegram notifications a lot. So it would be nice if you got a Telegram notification when someone sponsors the event. So let's do that. So we have webhook and how I'm going to set this up is when a new record of sponsor is created, I want this webhook to trigger, and I'm going to use Telegram. So Telegram has this API where you can send messages via bots to groups. So this is the API URL. And here we can customize the JSON request body using Jinja. So I get the doc as context, so I can do this and fetch the details from the DOM. So let's try this again. So this time I'm going to do silver. So yeah, we got the notifications. This is a test group that I created. Yeah, this works. Cool. What else do I have? Okay, I think that's all I have. Am I on time? Okay. So yeah, what I also want to take your attention to is conference.yapmins.com is fully built on these features. Landing pages, registration, emails, payments, everything is built on these features that I showed you. Person added a host FastHack that is built on these features. FapayCloud.com support portal is built on these features, and landing pages obviously. So yeah, you can read the docs on fapayframework.com. Yeah, that's all I have. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the chat.
Thank you for the amazing demonstration, Faris. It was interesting to watch you build a brand new app just by creating a site on Fapay Cloud. If our audience has any queries related to this demo, now is the time to ask. You can ask your questions by adding them in the chat box below. So we have a question from Jignesh Shah here. If we had a show software got No. How are you copy pasting the metadata of doc type from VS Code to front end doc type? Paris, if you could answer that.
Let me just show you quickly how I do that. I am audible, right? And my screen is visible?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So let me go to a web page. So let's say I want to copy this. I just click on menu and click copy to clipboard. So in VS Code, what I did is if I paste this, it will just give me the JSON. And if I copy this JSON and paste it, it will handle it basically. So you can try it right now if you have a site ready. I hope that answers the question.
So you have another question from Salim. Can you upload the code to Git?
Okay, so yeah, I forgot to mention there is a hackathon demo. Let me just put the URL, which has all these implemented, and you can sign up and look at how I did this. I'm posting it in the chat. So all of those features are implemented here, and you can sign up to see the server scripts, the web pages, doc types, etc.
Okay, another question from Santosh S. Could you please mention about import and export to different servers?
I think I'll need a bit more clarity on that question.
There are a couple of more questions that are coming up in the chat for us. You can
Okay, I'll try to answer them in the chat itself.